Sarah, otherwise known as Yarnmugs on Instagram and Ravelry, and welcome to my second podcast. This is a podcast about my knitting and crochet, and if I've got time, I might speak about some new things I've treated myself to, and maybe even some books I've really enjoyed reading lately. I'm sitting in a different position today, got my Christmas tree up, got my cup of tea, so let's get started. First of all, I really want to say a massive, huge thank you to everyone that watched the first podcast, liked it, subscribed, and left me such lovely messages. I was blown away. I couldn't believe that anyone was watching it, but let alone leaving lovely comments. So thank you so much. I think my views were increased by the lovely Ali from Little Drops of Wonderful. In her podcast, she mentioned me, so thank you so much, Ali. I really appreciate that too. But yeah, no, it seemed to go down well and people seemed to like what I was showing. Yeah, so on with the second. So in the first one, I was working on my Nature's Walk blanket and I have finished that. I hope you can see, I might move back a little bit. Yeah. So I was joining the squares last time and now obviously they're all joined and then there's this beautiful edge. In fact, if I hold it up that way, you can see, I think the edge looks like hearts. Oh, it's so lovely. Yeah, I really love it. I love the blanket anyway and all the squares and the different patterns, but I think that the border, the joining, that's what makes it so lovely. Actually, I should open that up a little bit more. Very pretty. I think it's the prettiest blanket I've ever made, and this is a gift for a friend. She doesn't know she's receiving it, and I'm going to put it in the post tomorrow. I hope she likes it. And this is the lovely pattern by Sandra Paul, Cherry Heart Designs. And her patterns are amazing. And it's free. It's a free pattern. It's gorgeous. So once I finished that, I cast on another blanket. Cast on. Hooked on. It's a crochet blanket. Another crochet blanket. I'm often asked by friends to make baby blankets, which I love doing because they're nice and quick. And my latest go-to crochet pattern is this one. And this is called the Dainty Diamonds pattern. Can you see all the diamonds? This is by Ivy and Mabel from Etsy, and she's Ivy and Mabel on Instagram. And I've used Stylecraft Special DK yarns again, the same as my Nature's Walk. There's some similar colours in here. The request was for quite a neutral blanket. It's for a baby girl, but she didn't want it to be overly pink. So I went with the parchment and the mushroom colour, but they were so close in colour, I thought, oh, it was a bit wishy-washy, so I added grape, which I'm happy with, but I really hope that they like it too. But I love this. It's such an easy pattern, but so effective. And the edge on the pattern just is to do a simple double crochet edge, but I always like to try different edges. So I just did a few, what did I do? 1, 2, 3, 4 rounds of trebles. And then the edge is crab stitch, which I've never done before, but I'm really happy with it. And it gives a really lovely, lovely like cordy, cord type, no, that's not the word I'm thinking of. Braid, that's it, like a braided edge. Oh, it's really lovely. I don't know if you can really see. So yeah, I'm really happy with this. I always use Stylecraft for baby blankets because you can put them in the machine and you can tumble dry them, and I've done that, and it's so drapey and floppy and it's nice and big. And I tend to do baby blankets about 45 rounds, and that seems to be plenty big enough. Now, I always tweak patterns a little bit, just, you know, if I can't understand what they mean, or I try and sort of work it out myself. And for this pattern, it suggested that you turned the work every time you did the new round, but I just couldn't get the knack of that. So I just kept going round and round. And in fact, it is a perfect square. It's not skew-width at all. And when I sometimes do granny squares, they sometimes end up looking a bit skew-width, but this doesn't at all. I was going to tell you about the hooks that I use, my crochet hooks. I use these Addy, I think they're called Addy Swing. Can't remember, they look like toothbrushes. I use a size 5 hook for that baby blanket. And the nice thing about these is that they do come in lots of different colours. Yeah, I like them. When I used to use the thin metal crochet hooks, I'd always get wrist ache, and since I've been using these, I don't get that. They're quite ergonomic. I quite like it. I tend to hold my hook like that. Typically, the one I use quite a lot, the 5, is a brown. You think, oh, out of all the lovely colours, I end up having to use a brown one. But so yeah, that's what I use for my crochet, and I've got every single size possible. So after I finished that blanket, I then restarted quite an old pattern. Quite a while ago, I offered to test knit a fingerless mitt pattern, which is a really lovely pattern, but I hated the needles that I was using. So I undid it all and restarted it again. And this is a pattern by Gardening Witch Designs, who's my friend Jane. And she says that she uses this pattern for when she teaches students to magic loop. So I don't know if it's an actual pattern at the moment to be purchased, but this is it. It's lovely, it's really lovely, really simple. And like I say, this is my first mitten I've ever made, but it's very simple. But the one thing that I learned something new on was an afterthought thumb, which I've never done before. Yeah, it's lovely. I've got two of them. Now from here, you might be able to see what I did wrong. I made two right hand mittens, but when you put them on, you can sort of turn it round a little bit. So yeah, no one would ever know. And why I wanted to make these, not only because I wanted to make a pair of mittens, but because I also already, ages ago, had made a hat and a cowl, and I wanted a matching set. So ages ago, I made this hat pattern. This is from, designed by Kay Jones. It's the angel hat, and also by Kay Jones, the Handbrake Cowl. I'm gonna pop it on. Oh, it's lovely. And now I've got the mitts to match. Put these back on again. Yeah. So this is acrylic yarn, but it's got 10% wool in. I'll just take these off. It was from a bargain bucket in my local market, and it was really, really cheap. Oh, look at my hair. Anyway, I've had it for ages. It's quite chunky. I've made several of these hats out of it, and now I've got a matching set, and I've still got some yarn left, so yeah, that will go into something else in the future. So Jane from Gardening Witch is a fantastic pattern, and she should definitely release it as a pattern for people to purchase, because it's perfect. Perfect for new knitters, because it's just knitting and purling, but that afterthought thumb was it's genius. Really, really good. So after I made those, I was really keen to make some more mittens. And I've got loads of 100 gram, like one skeins of yarn, Let me just have a cup of tea, actually. Hold on. Oh, I forgot to mention, actually, in the comments, one person commented that the acoustics weren't very good and they couldn't always hear my voice. So apologies for that, and thank you for letting me know. I record on an iPad, so I've turned the volume up full, so hopefully my voice is a bit louder. I also film in my conservatory, which is near the motorway and a train track. So yeah, please let me know if there are any other issues with the sound. But it's also really cold in here, so that's why I'm going to keep grabbing a cup of tea. Okay. So I was saying I've got all of these, lots of single skeins of yarn, and I saw a lovely picture of some mittens on Instagram that I was inspired to make myself, and I found it was from the fantastic Tin Can Knits, who are really brilliant, and they've got loads of tutorials, a fantastic website, loads of free patterns, and really guides you through those simple patterns, but you know, the basics. It's fantastic. So they're called the World's Simplest Mittens, and the pattern calls for all different weights of yarn and gives you the instructions for all of them. So the yarn I have is fingering weight, but I wanted to make them in a DK weight. So I wound the ball up and split them in half, and now I'm holding two yarns together. And I'm so pleased with them, it's so lovely. So this yarn is from Truly Hooked, and I bought this yarn at Fiber East this year. Truly Hooked. And it's in the Trance colourway. And she was raising money for Mind charity. And I think like £10 of the cost of the yarn went to that charity. So she's raised loads of money. So I was really happy to buy this. And with using this double, it's making such a lovely texture, lovely. So here's my mitten so far. Well, those colours are really popping. So it's in a grey and white with, like say, these pops of neon. And there I've got a thumb gusset. So that's again another sort of new way of making a little thumb. And now I'm working my way up the hand, and I'm nearly at the point where I'm going to decrease to close it, and then I can add the thumb. I just want to show you it on. Oh, also, going back to the needles, when I was saying about my mittens, that when I was first making these, I hated the needles I was using. They were just sort of plastic ones with a really horrible cord. I treated myself quite a couple of years ago to the Lykke, I can't remember what they're called. I should have got them. They're here anyway, but they're birch, I think they are, and they are so smooth. The cord is not particularly bendy like the Hiya Sharps cord, but it's still okay. Anyway, I'm just going to put it on for you to show you what it looks like. Oh, it's so nice. It's got quite a big cuff. It was 20 rounds of 1x1. Oh, those neons are really popping out, aren't they? So yeah, not much more, I don't think. A few more rounds, and then I can start decreasing and closing it. Probably get that done tonight. So quick. And here's my two, so I should have plenty to do the second. So yeah, I'm really, really pleased with that. And the yarn is beautiful. It's superwash merino and nylon. They'll be nice and warm. And the bag I've got them in is this really cute autumn bag, foxes, and it's by Antler and Acorn, and that's what she is on Instagram as well. But it's a very soft, it's just a thin bag, but squashes up. So that's what they're in. I also cast on a sock. Now, I think I talked last time about not wanting to use the really expensive, pretty indie dyed yarn for my socks and going back to using commercial yarn, which is what I have done. So I've made one. I'll just put it on a blocker. Yeah, lovely. So this is a contrast cuff, this pink here. And the contrast, I'm not going to try and say this, I want to say it's Scheepjes, but I'm sure it's pronounced something else, Invicta Extra. So I've got this yarn in lots of different colours for contrast. And then the actual patterned yarn is Drops Fabel print in the colourway, it's a number, 911. And I'm not particularly Christmassy, but I thought these look quite Christmassy with the red and the green. But how lovely with the pink. Who would have thought pink and red go together? So this is just a plain sock, 2x2 rib. I've got a particular sort of recipe that I like for me. I've got it written down here. Yeah, so I tend to do 30 rounds for the leg. I often follow the vanilla latte sock pattern just for the basic things like with the heel and the toe. They always seem to work out really well, but it's a heel flap and gusset, which I really like, heel turn. And then the length of the leg, or foot rather, how many did I do for that? Oh, 30 as well. So 30 and then the decreases. Now, the amazing thing that I think for me, and my feet are only a size 5, but out of 50 grams of this yarn, I split the yarn into two and I can get, yeah, a sock out of 25 grams. Now, I have got a little, so out of the 25 grams, For this, that's all I had that left. So that makes me feel really lovely, using up every little bit, not wasting lots. I mean, any wastage can go into another blanket, but I really love that. But I use higher sharp needles. I use a 2.5 needle and an 80 centimeter cord. And like I say, these are really bendy, these cords, and the needles are very sharp. So I've started the next one. So yeah, I do cuff down. Yeah, so I was really pleased with them. Well, they look lovely. And like I say, I've got lots of commercial yarn, and that's my plan. I'm just gonna make socks out of them. Oh, the other thing I was gonna say, I do love the look of a contrast toe heel cuff. But I find, and it might just be me, the way I don't pick up stitches well enough, or it just feels like it's a bit of a weak point. So sometimes, you know, holes appear. So I'd much rather use the same yarn all the way through. And if I wanted them a bit longer, then I'd add a toe in a different colour. But yeah, if I can just stick to the cuff being different and then using the main yarn all the way through, that's much nicer for me. It's so disappointing when you spent all that time making something and then you start seeing holes. I hate that. So that's them. Ooh, one on the floor. Let's have a bit of tea. I thought I'd also talk about an old project that I made. And since it's Christmas, I thought I'd talk about an old Christmas Eve cast on that I did. A couple of years ago, some indie dyer had put out a request for people to name the colour of their new yarn, and I won. And I won the colour choice of this. And I named this Winter Rhubarb, which I think suits it quite well. Now this is the Twas the Night Before Christmas socks by Danielle Jorge, or Danny from Little Bobbins Knits podcast. It's a lovely pattern. Yeah, see lots of sort of golds and browns through there. So yeah, when I won the name choice, I thought, oh, I've got to buy the yarn for that, and made myself some lovely socks. Lovely. So that's them. I also thought, I'll tell you about some things I've treated myself to. Where are they? Going back to Jane from Gardening Witch, she has got a fantastic Etsy shop and she makes lots of things for crafty people. And she made this lovely project bag, drawstring, and it's got, obviously, it is quite Christmassy, but I think it's lovely just for sock knitters anyway. So Jane has a lovely, such a well-made bag, it's beautiful. Can't wait to use that. I'll just show you her little Gardening Witch designs. Yeah, she's got some fantastic things. So I treated myself to that. I also treated myself to a new bag and some notepads. I love a notepad. I've always got a notepad on the go with all my, what I'm making at the moment, ticking off my rows and things like that, and writing little notes. But I really love these. Now I've got t-shirts in these as well. Yarnivore, knitter and crocheter, because I am all three. And these are from Stitches Tees. So you probably know Vicky Brown from Vicky Brown Designs. Let me just check that. Because, yeah, Stitches Tees on Instagram and stitchestees.com. And again, they produce lots of different things, sweatshirts, t-shirts, things for the stitcher or crocheter. Now, I treated myself to a stitcher bag because in January, I'm going to do a sewing course for 5 weeks with my sewing machine because I really want to learn how to use it. My sister is a fantastic sewer and is making all her own clothes lately, and I really want to do that too. So yeah, that was my treat to have. Oh yeah, look, also these little notepads with the dots. Yeah, lovely. They're really cheap, these as well. I know it's only a little brown notepad, but they're so nice to have, aren't they? So I got that. And a really big treat, and it was a big treat. When I first started watching podcasts, I really got into watching The Grocery Girls. I'm sure everyone else has watched them. And a couple of years ago at Edinburgh Yarn Festival, I bumped into Tracy from The Grocery Girls, and she gave me a little badge. But a few podcasts ago, they mentioned that they were doing a Christmas package. And obviously they live in Canada, so having to pay for taxes and all that malarkey. But anyway, it's really gorgeous though. So I got this yarn. Oh, and it does come with a couple of contrasts. I'm not going to obviously make socks with this. I'm going to make something else. That'd be a nice shawl, probably. Look at the speckles. So it came with yarn, a tiny little bag, and some really lovely stitch markers. Little wooden sock talk. This is all the little phrases. Hat chat. Yeah, they're lovely. Grocery Girls, really cute. And it also came with a little recipe for Christmas. So that's nice. Crunchy party mix. Yeah, look, how lovely is that? Their little emojis, looks just like them both. So yeah, that was quite an expensive treat, but I thought, oh, I will. I'll treat myself. Let's see how we're doing for time. I think to finish off, I'm just going to chat about a few books that I've read. Before I got into knitting and crochet, I was a massive bookworm. And then since knitting and crochet became more of what I did in my spare time, reading went on the back burner. But this year, the whole of this year, I've really tried to read a book a month, and sometimes I've exceeded that. But I've read some rubbish books this year as well, but some really good books too. And more recently, I've read some fantastic books. So this one is amazing. Oh, it's so lovely. Every page is beautiful. It's so well written. I'll keep it there so you can write it down if you need. And it's about two women who experience cancer and have a colostomy bag. And that's really, really good and really, really interesting. But it's also about family and about mental health. And I think why it touched me was because my job, I'm a nurse and a health visitor, and I obviously work with families who sometimes children are removed or have to live with their grandparents, and that happens in this book. Yeah, it's amazing. I'd really recommend people read it. It's so, so good. Really lovely. So that's the first one. And then the second one that I really enjoyed is this one. And it's like a true story. This one is not a true story, but at the end, the author does speak about her life and there are some similarities. But this one is a true story. And this is about a woman who also worked in the NHS and developed early onset dementia. And this really struck a chord with me as well, mainly because my memories and my brain is rubbish lately since going through the menopause. But it's a really positive book. So you think, oh, it's going to be quite depressing, but it's really positive. I really enjoyed it. And again, I'd really recommend people read that, because a bit like cancer, everyone's going to know, you know, someone that's experiencing dementia as well in the future. So it's really important book to read, and really struck home how sort of lack of understanding, and even our lack of understanding in the NHS about how to treat people or talk to people or care for people. Before I did this job now, health visitor, I worked with older people. That was a lot of experience in that. And then a friend loaned me this lovely book. And this is beautiful. I mean, you can read it just in a half hour, because it's just lovely little words of wisdom with beautiful pictures. And he is on Instagram. It's Charlie. I think it's called Charlie Maxi or Makesy. But the pictures, honestly, they're really lovely. And the little phrases that come out that he's written. Let me just try and find one. Oh, this one here. What do you want to be when you grow up? Kind. It's really touching. So yeah, that's lovely. So it's in hardback at the moment. And this is, I'm going to return this to my friend, but yeah, definitely follow on Instagram, because he's got some really lovely, heartwarming. And then another little book I read was this one by Floella Benjamin. Obviously a child in the 70s and 80s, I grew up with Floella Benjamin on children's TV. And this is her story about her coming over to England during sort of the Windrush era. This is so sad, though. I felt quite ashamed and embarrassed when I was reading this about how black people were treated when they came. But this story is very easy to read, and I think it was adapted as a film for children. But it's definitely something that we should all read. And at the minute I'm reading another book which is also based on that, based on the generation after the Windrush, like the people came to England and then settled here and had children. It's about that generation of children. And again, that's quite depressing and sad, but really important to read. So yeah. So yeah, they're my recommendations. When I thought about doing a second one, I kept thinking, oh, am I going to have enough things to talk about? But in fact, the time just flies by so quickly. And the fact that I've managed to finish quite a few projects and start a few new projects, I'm really, really pleased with that. So my plan for December is to finish the sock and finish the mitten. And then maybe December the 1st have a new cast on, which might be a sweater. I have got the yarn for that. But yeah, I really want to get everything sort of, all these two things finished. I have still got that shawl that I showed you last time. I should really try and do that. I might try and do that in December as well. So I think that's probably it. Oh, I didn't really mention what I was wearing. This is the first shawl I ever knitted, and it's in the beautiful travel knitter yarn. This is like baby camel in the colourway Jazz Age. And I had some leftovers and I thought, oh, I'm going to make myself a little flower. And this flower is a free pattern by Emma Potter, Potter and Bloom. And then I just made it a bit bigger. I added an extra round. I thought I might start doing that. With any spare yarn, I'm going to make a little brooch. This shawl was by Susan B. Anderson, and I think it's the Yowza shawl. Now, it's fine around my neck, but I don't really like the shape of it. It's so long and thin, but yeah, I suppose you find that out, don't you? The more shawls you make, the more shape you know what you like and what fits nice. But this is so lovely and squidgy. I love it, and the colour, oh, it's amazing. So, I think that's it. Thank you for watching. Please, yeah, feel free to leave me any messages if there are any problems with this episode, if it's been too noisy, or if you've not heard me, please let me know. Merry Christmas to everyone who celebrates that, and hope you all have a happy new year, and hopefully I'll see you again in January. Okay, thank you. Cheers.